Hey everybody, Star here. What is going on? We're going to be talking about Spy today, in particular starting with the red tape recorder. Here you can see it being used with engineers all over the place, and it's still able to de-level everyone's buildings because it acts extremely quickly. Here you can see me taking down a level 3 wrangled sentry, coming over here backstabbing these fools while their medic just sadly watches, and as I come back, already, that is a level 1 sentry that had an engineer babysitting it that whole time, because it goes down incredibly quickly. Even if you are babysitting your sentry and you're just, you know, turned around repairing your dispenser for a brief second and a spy with the red tape recorder saps your sentry, you are probably going to have a level 2 or a level 1 sentry after that. It is really an incredible sapper. I'm going to say in all situations, it is a straight upgrade to the regular one, and I've taken some time to not really immediately report on the red tape recorder, I suppose, because when it did initially come out, it was incredibly buggy, but I guess it's been a while, and this is the place where Valve wants it, or at least for now, they want it to be incredibly awesome. And even for mini sentries, one thing I have to say is that the red tape recorder doesn't immediately destroy them the way the regular sapper would, and that is actually a really good thing. Engineers don't care if you destroy their mini sentries whatsoever, because they can instantly rebuild them for 100 metal, which they could probably get that 100 metal just from picking up the destroyed mini sentry that you just blew up. So the interesting thing with the red tape recorder is you can't destroy your own sentry while it is being sapped. So please, even if you guys don't play Spy and you see a spy sap a mini sentry, leave it alone! Don't destroy it. It is a good thing that it is not destroyed. They cannot build their mini sentry during the time where it is sapped, and the red tape recorder will leave it in that state for a really, really long time. Even if they're using a regular sapper, you really shouldn't even bother with it. It's already going to be destroyed, and no engineer really stops to repair mini sentries. That is a waste of their time. You should be happy if they're doing that. But of course, with level 3 sentries is where it shines, because it does reduce their levels incredibly quickly, and obviously destroying a level 1 sentry is way easier than destroying a level 3, and the real part about this, why it's so good, is just how fast it happens, where even if the engineer is standing right next to a sentry, if he is distracted for even a brief moment, you can take his sentry down to a level 2, and then if nobody is protecting him and really watching what's going on, he's going to stop it from being sapped any further. It's going to be a level 2, and then you can just sap it again, shoot at him a few times with your revolver, and just keep annoying him until it's down to a level 1. It's pretty easy to get sentries down to level 1. It's really disgusting how easy it is to do it. The thing that's really a shame about the red tape recorder is it has got to be annoying engineers a lot. If you are an engineer, you need to stay absolutely vigilant at all times, because like I said, if you turn around for a brief second and a spy uses this on your sentry, you're going to lose a level on it, even if you are right there. And the whole reason engineers got mini sentries in the first place is so that they could leave home, go roam around in the pastures, but now you can't do that if you have a level 3 at all. You know, maybe before you had a little bit of leverage to walk away from it for a brief moment, fire some shotguns, come back, but if you do that now, you're gonna have to rebuild your sentry, pretty much. And that about sums that up, so we're gonna jump on over here onto our next topic. Oh-ho, that medic is dead. And he is not even our next topic. What I actually wanted to talk about was the Enforcer, because the Enforcer a while ago did actually get nerfed, and since then I've wanted to mention it and talk about it, but I haven't really played Spy at all, so we're going to take the time now to say the Enforcer has in fact been nerfed. And I feel a little bit less bad about using it now, because it's not as incredibly awesome as it once was, but it still is the Enforcer that we know and love, because the nerf actually wasn't really all that effective. It's basically the same weapon. The damage bonus that you get from the Enforcer no longer exists when you are in disguise. So you need to fire one shot, come out of disguise, and you'll get a 20% damage bonus. And they also nerf the fire rate so it takes longer to shoot. Which, actually, both of those things aren't that bad. I like the first one, the fact that when you're disguised, blah blah blah, because it makes it a little bit less brain dead. You need to actually think, oh wait, maybe I shouldn't shoot here because I don't have my damage bonus yet. I'll put in a little bit more effort to get it, and yeah, that's nice. But the whole fire rate thing doesn't really make a difference whatsoever, because what you really should be doing is firing a shot, aiming, then firing a shot, and the reduced fire rate isn't so much that it makes that big of a difference, and you are aiming during that time. And also, an interesting thing to note about revolvers, if you didn't know, if you wait 1.25 seconds, your shot will be perfectly accurate. So if you fire, wait that amount of time, your next shot will be perfectly accurate. So the fire rate reduction, in some twisted way, actually kind of helps if you're gonna wait for that. And truly, it's not a big deal. Just wait, aim, hit all of your shots. If you hit all of your Enforcer shots because you actually aim them, that is enough to kill everybody forever, always. And then, of course, there are no more random critical hits for the Enforcer, which I'm sure everyone is thankful for, but this update was May 31st. I'm really, really talking about this pretty late, aren't I? But one last thing before I go, which I actually completely forgot throughout the entirety of this video, is that if you notice at the bottom left corner of the screen, which I'm sure you've noticed because I've been disguising and has been creating the whole disguise icon nonsense, is I have class color indicators now for my HUD because I have been even more forgetful lately. I have been non-stop forgetting what team I'm on, so now it shows what class you're playing and what color team you are on for that class. Quite helpful! So if you want to download that, it is on my main channel page on the right-hand side, as it usually is. And I will catch you guys next time for even more Team Fortress 2. I hope this video wasted even a little bit of your time while you're waiting for Man vs. Machine to come out, or while you're waiting for the item servers to come back up after Man vs. Machine. So, see ya.